Good afternoon, and all of you. Now, here to continue further with exercise 12.2, question number 7, 8, and 9. Question number 5 and 6 will be again homework for you. So, question number 2, 4, 5, and 6 will be homework for this exercise. 1 and 3 I have solved it earlier. So, I am continuing further with question number 7, 8, and 9. So, this is question number 7, which says that this is the shape of a square. And this is the shape of an isosceles triangle, and it has been divided in three parts. This is the first part, this is second, and this is third. The diagonal of square is given as 32 cm. So as you know that the diagonals of squares are perpendicular bisector. So perpendicular means they will form 90 degree wherever they are meeting, and bisector means they are equally bisected. So it was 32, so it became 16, 16, and this also 16 and 16. Base of isosceles is given as 8 and the equal sides are given as 6. Now we have to find that ki how many different, made of 3 different shades, how much paper will be needed for each different shape, for first, second and third. It means we need to find it out the area of first part, second part and third part separately. So as you see that ki first, in the first part we can easily apply the area of right angle triangle. As the base is total of 32 and the height is of 16, so we can easily apply half 32 into 16, that is half base into height. This cancels 16 times, 16 into 16, that becomes 256 centimeters square. So this is the area of first. Same way when you see the area of second, here also the base is 16, oh sorry, base is 32 and the height is 16. So area of second also you may calculate in the same way. So half into 32 into 16. So this will be also 256 centimeter square. So area of first part and area of second part both will be 256 centimeter square. Now the third part is an isosceles triangle. So if you don't know the formula for isosceles, that doesn't matter. As you know the formula for Heron's, that Heron's formula would be applicable for the three sides of the triangle when it is given. So we'll go for Heron's formula for finding the area of the same. So first of all we'll find the semi-perimeter, that is 6 plus 8 plus 6 by 2, that becomes 20 by 2 and that equals to 10. So area becomes 10, 10 minus 6, 10 minus 8, 10 minus 6, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So this will become now 10, 10 minus 6, 4, 10 minus 6, 4, 10 minus 8 become 2. Now you are seeing that if a pair of 4 is already there, and 10 can also be bracketed as 2 into 5. So let's break it into as 2 into 5. 4 is already in pair and 1, 2 is already in pair. So 4 is in pair, 2 is in pair, both will come outside of the bracket. That become 4 into 2 root 5. So now we'll here apply the formula of root 5. Our value of root 5 as value of root 5 is 2.24. So value of root 5 we'll put it and get the value of it. That become 8 4 the 32, 2 carry 3, 8 is the 16, 3 19, 9 carry 1, 8 is the 16 and 17. So area of third part came out as 17.92 centimeter square approx. You mention approx as value of root 5 is not tabulating, so that will always give you the approx value. So that become area as 17.92 centimeter square. So first part will require an area of 256 centimeter square. The sheets which is required, that is asked for how much paper is needed for each type. So for area of 1 we require 256 cm square of paper, for area of 2 256 cm square of paper, and for the third we require area as 17.92. So it is actually the area of third. So area of third is calculated as 17.92. So this way you got the answer. As in the last class, I have told you the first question, which was the answer was coming as 30 plus 6 root 35. I don't know whether you have calculated or not, but I was worrying that whether you have calculated the value of root 35 or not. So do write the answer of first, which was left, that area of ABCD came out as 30 plus 6 root 35 area of quadrilateral, and it was asking the area of total figure. So we'll find the area of root 35. Value 35 came out as 5.92. It was, I calculated it as 5.92. So that given 30 plus 35.52. 35.52. So and when you add it, this is 65.52 centimeter square across. So that is the exercise 12.2 first question, which was there related with the last video. So first question, I have left the answer here only. I told you that you should find the value of root 35, put the value and then get the answer. So I was thinking whether how to tell you again. So I have calculated the value of root 35, which I got it as 5.92. And I have kept there to get the final answer of that particular quadrilateral. So it came out as 65.52. And in the seventh question, I have calculated the area of first part, second part and third part separately. First part, half base into height, base was 32 and the height is 16. Same for second part, base is 32, height is 16. And third part, although it was forming an isosceles, so I have applied the Heron's formula to get the area of that particular figure. So it came out as 17.92. So this is the answer of 7. So now I'll go for question number 8. Question number 8 says that a triangular floral design is there, and it is made up of 16 floral designs, and the dimension of that triangular floral design is given as 9 cm, 28 and 35. 9 cm, 28 cm and 35 cm, that's the side of floral design, triangular floral design given, and there are such 16 floral design, and need to find the cost of polishing that particular design at the rate of 50 paise per centimeter square. You need to find total cost of polishing at the rate of 50 paise per centimeter square. So first of all, we need to find the area of one triangular floral design, then we multiply by 16 to get the area of 16 floral design, and then we multiply by cost to get the total cost of polishing. So first, finding the area, we need the semi perimeter, that is 9 plus 28 plus 35 by 2, 35, 28, 63 plus 9, 72 by 2, that becomes 36. So area will be now 36, 36 minus 9, 36 minus 28 and 36 minus 35. So this becomes now 36, 36 minus 9, 27, 36 minus 28, 8 and 36 minus 35 becomes 1. As you know, the square root of 36 is 6 into 6. 27 is 9 into 3 and 8 is 4 into 2, 1 is as it is. So 6 from the pair came out, square root of 9, 3, square root of 4, 2 and root 6 as it is. So 6, 3 is 18, 18, 2 is 36, and I am putting the value of root 6, or at last I will put the value of root 6. So let it be continued at 36 root 6 centimeter square. That's the area of one floral design. Same way the area of 16 floral design will be 36 root 16 into 16, and then the cost of polishing will calculate of 16 floral design. Cost of polishing of 16 floral design at the rate of 50 paise per centimeter square, that becomes 36, root 6, the value of root 6 is 2.45 and to 16 and 50 paise, so that becomes 50 by 100. So this cancel 2 time, 2 cancel it 18 time, 18 into 16, 86 is 108, 8 carry 10, 18 on the 18, 10, 200, 18, 10, 2.45, 288 into 2.45, that becomes 705.6. 705.6. So the cost of polishing for 16 floral design came out as 705.6. 705 rupees 60 paise. So this way will be calculated. Explaining again, as the sides of floral design, that's a triangular, is given as 9 cm, 28 and 35. You need to find it out the cost of 16 such floral design at the rate of 50 paise per centimeter square. So first I have calculated the area of one floral design, which came out as 36 root 6. Same way, cost of 16 floral design will be when you multiply by 16. And when you need to find it out cost at the rate of 50 paise per centimeter square, the total area which you got, you when you multiply by 50 paise, so that become, as it was 50 paise, so converting in rupees, that divided by 100, that become 50 by 100. And then after doing all simplification, after putting the value of root 6, which came out as 2.45, I got the final answer as 705.6. So this is the answer of question number 8. Now reaching to question number 9, which is based on again a trapezium, which I have already shown you once in question number 3. There also a trapezium came, which I converted in the form of triangle and parallelogram to get the height first, and then I have calculated by using the area of trapezium. Same concept we are going to apply for this last question of the exercise, which is given as the shape of the trapezium is in such a way that its parallel sides are given as 25 and 10. So this I am taking as 10 and this is 25, and non-parallel sides are 13 and 14 meter. So this is 13 and this is 14 meter. Now you need to get the area of this trapezium. As I told you last time, that we will try to convert the trapezium in the form of parallelogram and triangle. So now I am drawing a parallel side from here with respect to this side. Excuse me for the figure, it might not be looking decent. So this is forming the shape of trapezium. Suppose I label it as A, B, C, D, E. So triangle A, E, C, D. Oh, sorry, parallelogram A, E, C, D. Or quadrilateral A, E, C, D is a parallelogram, and triangle CEB is a scalene triangle. Now as this is 13, so this will be 13, this was 10, so this was 10, and this remaining become 15 meter. So we got, first of all we need to get the area of this triangle CEB. So we need to calculate area of triangle CEB. For that, first require a semi-perimeter, 13 plus 14 plus 15 by 2, 15, 14, 29, 13, 42 by 2, that is 21. So now the area becomes under root 21 minus 13, 21 minus 14, and 21 minus 15. S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So this become under root 21, 21 minus 13, 8, 7, 6. Now we'll try to form the pair, split in such numbers, like 21 can be written as 3 into 7, 1, 7 is already here. 8 could be written as 4 into 2, and 6 could be written as 2 into 3. So seeing that pair of 2 is there now, 3 is there, 7 is there, and 4 is already a perfect square number. They all will come outside of the bracket. 3 is in pair, 2 is in pair, 7 is in pair, and square root of 4 becomes 2. So 3 2s are 6, 2s are 12, 7s are 84 meter square is the area. I have told you that after getting the area, again you may go for area of triangle as the same triangle area you have calculated, and that could again be shown it as half base into height. So area of triangle is 84. As we require the height of this particular trapezium, because unless and until you get the height, you won't able to find the area of trapezium. So suppose I am taking it as M. So area of triangle is half base into height, 15 into H. So value of height become 84 into 2 by 15. Or if you simplify by 3, 28.5, that becomes 56 by 5 meter. No need to reduce it in decimal, because again you need to do one more calculation related to the area of trapezium. That area of trapezium is half into sum of parallel side into height. So before reaching for that, I am repeating it again. It was given a trapezium whose parallel sides are 10 and 25, non-parallel sides are 13 and 14. So first of all, we'll try to convert this trapezium into a parallelogram by drawing a parallel side along this side. As this side is already parallel and this side parallel we are drawing, it means two opposite sides become parallel, so it forms a parallelogram. And the rest part, this is triangle. So this is 13, so this becomes 13. This is 10, this becomes 10. Total was 25, 10 is given for parallelogram, so remaining side become 15. So triangle side is now 13, 14 and 15. So first we get the semi-perimeter and then we get the area. So we got the area as 84. I have told you that after getting the area, you go for half base into height to get the height of that particular triangle. So we are using the same concept, as it is height is being dropped on the base 15. So base will be 15, height we need to calculate, and area already calculated as 84. Putting all the values, we got the height as 56 by 5. So after getting the height now we can go for the formula of area of trapezium. As you know that area of trapezium is half into sum of parallel side into height. So parallel sides are 10 and 25 and height calculated as 56 by 5. So 25 plus 10, 35 by 2 into 56 by 5, 5 sevens are 2, 28, 7 into 28, that become 196 meter square. So area of this particular trapezium is 196 meter square. Always remember, when a parallelogram is when a trapezium is there, so unless and until you get the height of that trapezium, you cannot apply the formula for area of trapezium. So this all process was done to get the first of all height of trapezium. After getting the height, you can easily apply the formula of trapezium, that is half sum of parallel side into height. So after putting all, we got final area as 196 meters square. So I hope you have understood now how to apply the formula of Heron's to get the area when the sides are given. So that Heron's formula could be applicable for equilateral triangle also, isosceles also, scalene also. Means to say, wherever the sides are given, you can easily go for Heron's formula to get the area of that triangle. This is all about Heron's formula. Stay safe, stay happy. Thank you and Jai.